character if he makes bad moves in Princess Yoshi.
Yes.
Yeah.
No, I agree. I agree.
Don't give me that. I was like, no. I actually know this for sure. Like,
this is something I'm very sure of.
Okay, so we're jumping right into this. So immediately off the bat, we saw Wes get that cross slash, and like Dyer was like, yo, have an egg with that slash.
Yep.
It was beautiful.
Yeah, I think Cloud, kind of a like Sheik in the sense that his frame data in the air is good enough that you can just kind of work off of hits just in random situations too. Like, Sheik can definitely just go for those fares sometimes when Mike gets like a back air at low percents. That was nice. That was very pretty.
It was pretty.
Moment.
It was like a wow. That pummel was sending his teammate a little bit with the pummel. It was unfortunate.
That could have been a bad situation, but it's alright. Definitely only taking some percent.
Have you ever noticed that Kirby's pummels are just like lightning quick? He's like,
you know, give me the money. Give me the money.
He's like, you have 6 seconds to live, and then you're done.
Yeah. Just hold it.
You hold it. You take it.
Give me the money.
Buddy Big. Dude, I'm sorry. I gotta pay rent. Yo, he killed his teammate.
Oh,
unfortunate.
So unfortunate. I imagine Kirby is just like a super gritty voice, low key. Like he makes cute noises, but when he actually
Danny
talks,
DeVito
like,
is the voice of Kirby. I've been over this.
Have you ever seen a frog kid? Dude, It's Always Sunny is such a good show.
But Joe, I'm a big fan.
That was good.
Dude,
they keep doing
cross-slash
there. That's so much
like,
damage.
Like, Wes, this is what boggles my brain, is Wes lands all the cross-slashes, but the second it's limit, he misses
yeah,
them. It's because he's, like, holding on to it, and they're super aware. They're like, okay.
Wow, good punish there by Wes. Yeah. Killed him for getting
Dill's
his own
already on his last stock.
Yep. That's what...
Was Yoshi the answer? Is Yoshi
I
the answer?
I think... I was definitely wrong in thinking that Yoshi would be bad against this team because he's using a lot of egg
situations. And he like has all three of his stocks still.
Yeah. He's stock taking so well because already inherently being... Okay.
They're just not going to let him back on stage. Like, this dude, it was, this dino needs to die. He was supposed to die a million years ago. What happened, Wes? What happened, Wes? He had a limit. He was laughing up there.
That sucked. Okay, nice up air, 5 West. Another up air. Showing off what a good jungler Cloud is.
I'm just kind of mad right now. Like, that's such a comfy lead.
Yeah,
that's such a comfy lead. And West is just like, nah, I want this to be more stressful.
I think they should be a little bit okay because their stock tank definitely is holding on to the 2 stocks that he needs.
Yeah.
Wow, that was a great nair by Dyer. He's using these down airs at ledge so well.
Wes and Dill, they just dodge rolled and then dodge rolled.
Yeah.
Like both at the same time.
They're having a nice little fight over there.
Oh, yeah. Beautiful dance, beautiful ballet. I like Wes's coverage with the ledges.
Yeah.
Throwing his throw set that Derek covers almost a majority of the options.
Yeah.
See, that's the thing. When you try to punish cross slash, did that kill? When you try to punish cross slash, like that'll happen, you know?
Yeah.
They just throw out a quick move. But I really like what Wes was doing there while Mike Kirby was pummeling Dyer. He was just walking in, being able to go, I'm just going to get this set from the second he goes off.
That was smart there because Dyer had set himself up in a position to work off of the cross slash, but Dill immediately needled Wes so that he couldn't get the entire hit. This is going to be a scary position, though. You know, if he makes a wrong move, he's getting up smashed at later percents.
That was beautiful. Dyer like ran in there, put on all that shield pressure, and then Wes was on point to cover all the options at a shield. Because Wes was on the right side, Dyer's on the left side. If you dodge roll either way or spot dodge, you're gonna get in and punish you. You know, that was perfect.
Dude, that down air by Dyer killed so. I mean, killed so early.
Just gonna reset that. It's like I'm not gonna let you get the sword off. I'm just gonna go in there and dash attack. It's one of the things where you get a grab in a 2v1 and you're the one that gets the grab, it's sometimes you're gonna get punched no matter what. So unless you have like a certain throw, like Mario's back throw or something, and you gotta be very
Should
careful.
Be able to get the spike off this. Not enough. Wow, he just
the
went to the
up.
Heavens, man.
The mix-up. Because he did that because he knew that what Wes just did. He jumped, ran in there, did a dash dash.
He was like, 1-2, don't talk to me or my son ever again. He just flew to the heavens. Oh, there we go. That's what he's wanted for so long.
Yeah, Dyer's gone for that fair so much. He's desperate, dude.
Gotta be careful, though, because Mike keeps kind of getting to rack up percent when he does that unsafe dare. Because it looks good in some circumstances, but Mike just keeps back airing him out of shield, punching his jump, and he needs to be very careful about that.
Stressful battle for the cross slash Evan. Yeah. So stressful for Mike Kirby. Look, I mean, trying to, like, one thing when you're in that egg is a lot of people like to mash out as soon as possible, but
you gotta mix it up
because, like, as, you know, Dyer was doing there.
Oh, come on.
Unnecessary.
Man. Stop being rude, man.
Unnecessary up air. West shouting.
That's just
get
disrespectful, man.
This guy, I can't handle West.
Just be polite, man.
I have never heard West be this loud in my life. He's usually like the quiet, calm dude. He's just like screaming at the top of his lungs to get him out of here. Hetrick wins that game.
It's great. Back in the day, Wes was the really savage.
He's professional now.
Oh my god.
You guys can't hear Devin right now, but he's telling us stories about Wes.
Man, Devin has some stories.
Hey, Devin, when are you going to get a mic for yourself? You should.
That would be nice, man. Just tune in every once in a while.
Yeah, you know, like, obviously don't commentate with us, but, you know, you just we got story time. I bet chat would love to hear story time with Devin.
Yeah, man.
Oh, are we going to a map that's not FD?
Nah, dude, FD forever.
Nah, man, we might see the mix-up, the stage mix-up.
Please go to map that's not FD, man.
So I don't know what time this tournament's planning on ending, but my roommate just texted me. Is like, yo, Chinese? And I'm like, dude, don't tempt me, bro. I want to go home and eat Chinese with you, but
I mean,
I don't know.
You're in Chinatown. Just tell him to come
out
and get it here, man.
Where I live. I live in Chinatown in Brooklyn.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I live 5 minutes away from next level.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay. Nice.
Which is why that'd be cool if we got Smash tournaments there. But yeah. That's the dream. We'll see how that goes.
Yeah. You just need a TO to step up, get that going.
If only someone could do it, wink, wink, nudge, nudge, stream.
Yeah, man.
What? Why'd you nudge me?
I don't know. I'm just looking around suspiciously.
Yeah, okay, cool. Are they going to Omega Big Battlefield? That's pretty random.
Just don't think FT, man.
Dude.
Oh, come on.
One of my favorite things about CEO is when they do that timer, the 5, 4, 3, 2, when the people are taking too long to pick a stage. This would be like one of those times. It's like, just pick a stage. Yeah, play the Oscar music, dude.
Wait, are we on a different map?
Omega. It's still FD, but it's Omega Halberd.
No.
Wait, this is
actual Halberd.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. That song is such jams, though, so that's good.
Oh, legendary. Like, oh, dude, when you're playing Kirby's Air Ride, that low-key great game, and then you collect all three parts of the Dragoon, and you're flying on that thing. Oh, dude.
So good.
It's the best. You just feel so good. Because you're doing city trial. You're playing with your friends. Yeah. You get that one friend who has those parts memorized, where they're going to be. And they know exactly where each single piece spawns in all the blocks because they played it so freaking much. And they get it. And they have the Dragoon. It's like, why am I even trying anymore? It's like, you got the Dragoon. I'm going to lose the minigame.
I'm so sorry, man.
I've had a troubled... I had a very troubled... High school was troublesome. That's all I can say.
I'm so sorry, man.
Shout outs to my high school friend.
Oh, man. Dude, that's the second time getting to game two has taken that long.
And just to go back to FD.
Just to go back to FD. Same characters.
They tried.
Dyer getting a shield poke there on Dill.
Oh, nice.
I love the spacing from Dyer.
Yep.
Like, just throwing out them dares while Wes just holds it. Doesn't even bother throwing them. I'm going to let you take all this dare damage first.
That was a good idea by Wes, but poor execution.
But Sheik has a pretty fast dodge, but you got to be prepared for that.
Especially, it's so awkward, her forward roll, because she has two different animations where she just, like, skips and then goes back.
Did Dill just tech Wes's down smash? Like, the first hit?
Yeah, you're allowed to do that.
The second hit happened?
You're allowed to do that. That's
that
one of the best. That's one of the best counterplays to cause down smash, because if you hold down, if you DI down, it'll affect the first hit, so you can immediately tech before the second hit comes.
That's funny.
I think it's situational based on percent. I'm not 100% sure, but I know it works for sure, and that's one of the day one things that we find out.
That's funny. I can listen to Yoshi sounds all day.
Yoshi sounds are great. I like, my favorite thing about Yoshi is his victory theme.
Oh yeah, it's so happy.
Yeah, man.
Wow, get that cross slash.
I absolutely hate facing the character, but he's a happy guy.
He's wacky. He's wacky packy.
Yep. Still consistently getting the 50-50, but he's just Stalling it a little too much, and I think he's going to need that kill.
I love how Dire just fell down with that dare, knowing that Wes is going to send him to the left like that. It's beautiful.
So much cross-slash. Back throw. Oh, wow. Not getting that forward air. Too laggy of a move. It's hard to time.
Ooh. Oh.
Smart by Mike to apply that show pressure immediately after. Back throw. That's not going to be death. Back throw again. Smart by Mike to consistently back throw instead of doing up throw for now.
I didn't even see how Wes died. He died off the top?
I'm not sure.
Maybe he's just trying to purposely DK it. I'm not. Who knows?
Yeah.
It also might be a good option in doubles because it's a good mix-up if the teammate's going to try to save. Because that's the thing about Kirby's throws, is that like he does drastically different animations depending on what direction he pushes.
That was so smart by Dire. Such a good forward smash there. Oh, nice up smash by Dill, but that's not going to kill.
The man's at 176, living the dream. The definition of stock tank is right here, boys.
Dill power shielding immediately after both of those jabs.
Wow, you know, peace. I'm just going to hit all three of you and kill my teammate.
Peace. Say goodbye to that stock. But they still have that one stock lead, so that's good. Especially when Cloud is able to have two stocks. And Yoshi is just stock tanking the entire time. It's really good, because Cloud does a lot of damage in doubles.
Oh, yeah.
Good punish.
Ooh. This is... Dill, this is the tech, and Wes capitalizing on it. Wes is on fire right now.
Wes is...
I know it's Dire on him, Wes is on
fire. I was going to make the same pun, man. Great minds think alike.
Oh, dude.
Oh, man. That was such a... I don't know. I don't want to say it was a really bad idea, but like teching in there for Wes was just not smart because he gave Dill the chance to leave shield. Wow, just forward tilt, just swinging at him. Mike has to go.
Dill and Mike Kirby gotta mix something up. There's something going on.
I heard a scream come from up there.
This is a drastically. Oh my god, there goes Wes again.
Oh man.
DA 2003 DA Wes just screaming, getting him out of here as he's playing Grand Finals against them. This guy.
Oh, peace.
Get him out of here.
Oh, deuces. Just kick him in his mouth. Oh.
I mean, he's just gonna sit there all day and charge that limit.
Get your limit.
Sorry. I mean, I can't do anything. What is he going to do? Get baited into charging in?
Oh, later.
I love how Dire was in like the free fall animation before that. Like as he was falling down, he's like, I'm just going to throw this up air. He's in tumble and then throughout the up air.
It's great.
Ba-ba-ba-ba.
It's so good.
It's always that
so
last
good.
Note. That last note is so... it's money.
So good.
That last note is money. Because you know everything's going to be okay after you win. It's like, dun-dun-dun-dun. It's beautiful.
Man, I absolutely
It makes you reflect on the last game that just happened. It makes you think about all the wrong decisions and all the right decisions that you made. And then you can move on in the world, you know?
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
A little too in-depth.
Or is that too philosophical for us?
A little bit too philosophical.
Okay, cool. We're going to go to game three.
A lot of emotional connection to video games, like especially your Air Ride story. I definitely felt a lot of emotion for
Listen,
I feel like...
Video games and I have a deep past.
Everything's going to be
Which
right.
I think a lot of people here have, you know?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, no, my roommate just told me. After a certain point, I'll just end up getting Chinese. Don't do it. Sean, please, don't do it.
Get bodied, dude.
Okay. Town and City.
Yep. Yay.
If anyone's going to do the... I mean, they obviously were saying, well, FD didn't work twice, so let's just go to this stage. Maybe we can get some cool up throws with Kirby shenanigans, kill you off at like 40%.
Yeah, because the thing here is, with the exception of Yoshi, who I think the problem of him killing is nullified in doubles to some extent, especially with Cloud, who has such weak throws that can set up into him. You know, Wes doesn't need help killing. He's Cloud, he's going to do the damage anyways, be it Battlefield or Town. But Sheik and Kirby both definitely benefit from being able to kill a lot faster. And I think that's what they want, especially with such a good stock tank character like Yoshi. And, you know, such a just very good pressure character like Cloud is going to be. You're going to want to be able to kill faster than they are.
The faster you kill, the quicker they die.
Yeah.
Stating obvious statements 101.
Oh, nice up smash by Dire.
Man, Dire loves those fairs. He loves offstage fairs. That's like his favorite thing.
Yeah, man. Offstage fair. Wow, that was spooky. Dude. Mike and Dire both just go so deep against each other.
So there's no fear. These guys don't have fear in doubles. That's one of the things I love about seeing these dudes play, is they just have zero fear. They just, like, go in deep. They throw out attacks. They're like, I don't care if I get punished for this. Yeah, it's fun to watch them play doubles, because, like, they play doubles because they love doubles. It's not because, like of course they want to win, but, like, they're here to have fun.
And the up air from Dill actually coming into effect there, as we saw, you know, very good pick, Town and City.
That was very good. Mike Kirby tried to go off stage with the swallow, trying to get, like, an opponent.
Yep.
Realized he got Dill. So, like, you know what? I'll just take his power. Whatever.
That was a good option because he took his power instead of spitting him out. Because spitting him out could have, like, you know, put him in a really bad position.
Put him in a really bad position. And now he has needles. So, yeah. Let's see if he can do something.
Kirby with needles is terrifying. And in doubles, you know, both of them having needles is going to be able to combo, help each other combo from across.
Combo needles into needles into needles.
Stop.
It's beautiful.
That's gross.
It's a beautiful love story between two sheiks.
Dude, could you imagine if Kirby had sheik brain data?
No. I don't want to imagine that. That's not a world I want to live in.
Oh, wow.
I can't, literally, I take my eyes off Wes for like a second, and he kills himself. I don't know.
Mike being the stock tank of this game, just holding on to all three of his stocks.
This is Mike's stage.
Getting,
like,
a lot of kills.
Yes.
Such a good stage for Kirby.
Nice. Good coverage from Dire, because that normal crosshatch would not have killed him. But well, I'm surprised because of the lightweight nature of Kirby in crosslash at that high percent. He could have DI'd out of that, I'm pretty sure. But yeah. I guess he just... I saw him trying to as well, so maybe he just uses their bad spot.
I'm starting to see the point of Dire using that dare at ledge, because if one of the partners is on ledge and the other one is standing there, you can delay the dare through their shield, through the hit stun. So that, or the hit lag rather,
yeah.
That you're kind of able to cover ledge when you get down there.
And you make it so they don't know, like, you know, you get back on the ledge, it's like, you cover so many options. That's another thing with doubles, you have two people. If you have two people, you want to cover as many options as you can. Okay. Wow, jab into up B, okay.
Jab?
Classic Yoshi combo.
It's super scary, because, you know, you can't hold shield.
No.
This guy kind of dipped.
You just kind of like, yeah.
Up
that ledge is going to get the kill.
Peace.
Hey!
And that was at, like, the highest point, too.
That was so good.
This game they used that time for Dire to respawn to give Mike Kirby needles.
Oh no.
Okay.
All right, guys. You can calm it down now.
I'm calm.
I'm trying to go home in peace.
I am the calmest right now. I have my inner zen. We're all peaceful.
That was such a yellow downbeat.
Yeah. I mean, look at him.
That wasn't peaceful at all. He's just doing it.
He's looking for it. He needs the kill. You know? Sometimes you gotta go for that risky stuff. Stop it.
Peace.
This is mean. It's
Jesus
just mean.
Christ,
it's not rude. It's mean.
I'm so ready for Dill to just, instead of, like, trying to throw him again. I'm so ready for a top smash. It's gonna happen. Oh, man. If he had less needles, that was up smash there.
Here it is. Stone.
Oh. Good DI. Oh, peace.
Dire not giving up. This man's living.
Yeah, man. Wow. Oh,
and
peace, Dill.
That's exactly what he needs. He needs Dill to just kill himself like that. Just do it one more time for him.
Oh,
wow, that shield.
Later
to
your
shield.
Dude, Mike almost broke his shield for Dire.
Too high a percent. It's not going to work. Oh, my God. This is legitimately, like, terrifying.
Okay. For both teams.
Like a max, there it is. You just gotta get that single grab. That's all you need is that one grab with Kirby at that 100%. Done.
Yeah, man. Especially on Tao. In the words of Wes, get him out of here.
Yeah. Yoshi with hype, like max rage, kind of scary.
Yeah. Very, very scary.
Kind of scary.
It's like he just up smashes you at like 80 and then you die.
And it's like
pretty much no matter where you get hit on the up smash, it's such a scary move.
But now it's their counter pick. If I was the other two, I might want to just ban FD, because that seems to be working out super well for them. They're not going to go for it, though. I'm curious what their ban was. Maybe it was something like Lilac Cruise.
They most likely banned, I want to say Dreamland versus Cloud.
Yeah.
Because you don't want to deal with him having a lower ceiling on a platform map. And, you know, it's not like Pound where you're both gaining the ability to kill more, because you are. But the ceiling on FD is just as high, so Cloud's going to benefit more from having the platform than the other two characters are.
Oof.
Nice combo. Oh, Fairy. His partner and Quest there.
He's comboing Wes into Abyss and Beyond. But, you know, Wes is, once again, sitting on that limit.
Yep.
Looking for the most opportune time to just throw it out. I'm like you said earlier, I would like to see Wes do some more Blade Beam with that. The one time I saw these Blade Beam, it got the kill.
He got the snipe off map, and it's like when you're pressuring Kirby, who has to rely on his jumps more than he does his up B to recover, you know, you kind of want to kind of get the air dodge reading.
Also, the Blade Beam's safe. You know, like, if you're doing it from a long enough distance, like, you just throw it out there and see what happens.
Talk about Blade Beam that much kind of distracting me from what a beautiful cross slash that
was. Oh, yeah.
There. Utilizing
he saw him. He's like, I'm going to land right here. I'm going to throw this side view right here. And bada bing, bada boom.
One thing that I feel, just because of the way his hits work, the angle of the hits are, I think it's going to be a little bit hard for Dire to connect forward air, Mike specifically, off of the hits that Wes.
You see, like, Dill had to power shoot that last zero, so he would have been caught by that as well. Wow, that sneaky stone! That super sneaky stone from Mike Kirby off stage. Then gets the F smash on Dire. Very good patience from Wes to wait for his teammate to come into the platform. You don't want to jump out there early, but you both can be out at the same time.
There we go. All right.
Dire on top
Maybe
of
Maybe I was
thing.
Wrong.
Throw out that fair after the cross slash. My goodness. He just crazy stuff.
I was 100% wrong there. He definitely connected that forward air incredibly well there. Didn't get the spike, however. The damage it did, very good amount.
Man, Dire likes Uppy. I think he really likes Uppy.
Yeah. It's a good move. Oh, he tried to delay the hits through
yeah.
Mike to hit, through Dill to hit Mike.
Yeah,
well.
I saw what Mike was going for there. It just didn't work out.
Nice forward smash by Dill. Immediately changing the pressure back onto Dire after getting hit by Mike. Very smart. Nice. Putting himself as close to where they would be after the throw. Is that Deuces? Oh, no. Nice nair.
One thing that's, like, I find interesting is that Wes and Dire have not seen together in tournament for, like, I don't know, since, like, August. Like, it's been a very long time. And they're here, sitting at Grand Finals and keeping up with Dill and Mike Kirby, you know?
Yeah.
So it's just, like, kind of cool to see because, you know, they're bros. They're alive.
Yeah, man, they're
crew
so
members.
They've been crew members.
And they both love doubles, so.
Back air, upper, no.
Try to get that upper kill.
Nice forward air, but it's going to connect with his teammate. It's the idea that counts, though.
Mike went for that double jab. I like
yeah.
that. They cancel it so he didn't get the...
That was smart by Dill. Realizing that he was going to go for the cross slash, he did the jump air dodge. And Mike taking care of Dire as that happens. Now, they're relaxing. You know, Mike has been playing the lead of the stock tank incredibly well all set long. So if he's able to hold on to the stock, even if they kill Dill, they're maintaining the same exact stock.
Gets that bear. Try to break that shield.
Oh man, this is gonna be a combo video. The
thing is, Dire can easily bring this back. If he just gets two lucky kills, it turns into a singles match.
He needs to do
There's
oh,
one.
See, it was good, but it's a little bit unfortunate because if he was able to kill Kirby first, it would have been so much more beneficial.
Yeah. And Dill was on top of things. Like, he immediately, like, the second he died, you saw it. He, like, timed how he took that taunt. He immediately had that stock. He knew Dill wants to be the one in the 1v1 if it comes down to it.
Yeah, definitely in a 1v1 situation, because as Devin was saying earlier, Kirby doesn't do well against Yoshi. So in a one-on-one situation, it's going to play out just like a singles match. You know, nothing changes. You don't have a teammate to rely on. You don't have extra hits to rely on. Very good 50-50 by Dill. It's going to be good DI by Dire.
I like how Dill's just pretty much turned. This pretty much is kind of a 1v1 while Mike Kirby just hangs back, waits for Dire to throw out something open, because you don't want to be risky with it. Good tech from... Wow!
Nice.
That was an amazing ending. Mike Kirby got fared, sent into the ground. That would have killed him if he did not tech it.
Yep.
Then immediately, like, Dire's like, okay, if that doesn't work, I'm gonna expecting the tech. That's another thing I love when people do is when they expect the tech to
expecting
not kill.
Expecting the tech is one of the smartest things to do, especially because you see Lucas players do it a lot. When you get the down throw down air and they're in
yeah.
a tech situation, you just stick out a forward air. If they tech in place, it beats it. If they tech roll behind you or in front of you, it doesn't do anything. And if they miss the tech, you get that.
It's like stage spiking as well.
Yeah.
Like, always expect the tech, because if they don't make the tech, then whatever, you covered your option and it's fine. Yeah. They died.
You, got a little
you lose nothing for covering the option. So
yeah.
You might as well cover the option in case they tech. Oh, you should always be watching for that. Don't expect them to be stage spiked or anything, or like into the stage and into the ceiling.
Especially, like, you see this as a problem versus Falcon. When Falcon does up B, if you tech that, you can punish it like 9 times out of 10. So you need to find a different option in some of those situations. And I think it's a lot like that against more against Kirby and Yoshi than it is against
Sheik.
Yeah.
Because Sheik has the frame data to immediately come out of that move and stick out another hitbox. Like Nair, Fair are both good. Or even Bouncing Fish in some situations, because that frame 2 invincibility is going to help you out a lot.
Yeah.
But Kirby back air.
The 2 frames.
It's the animation is out for enough time that in some situations he's going to get punished for that. So, and forward air being a multi hit and having a little bit of aerial level. It's also going to be a problem.
Once again, going back to FD. Seems to be the DA stage.
Yeah. So there's definitely no objection. Wow, that was so smart. I reacted to that super late, but that was an incredibly smart down B by Dire, racking up that percent.
Yeah.
A common trait that we're kind of seeing in this match is whichever team, both teammates die first before the other team, tends to win. And it's happening in a lot of situations where, like, you'll see the games that Wes and Dire die first, you know, that's the game for them.
Yeah. I mean, you know, like, it's all about the momentum, man. Once you lose them, that was unfortunate. You can't do that. Not in Game 5 of Grand Finals. You can't do that shit.
Sage weak in the back.
Sage is giggling. Look at him.
Oh, man. Nice there. Punishing Mike for forward throwing.
That was an amazing tech. Detected it throughout that Nair. Very beautiful.
Immediately, can you knock over the off? So.
As we discussed earlier.
Yep. So many different ways to do it, but, one thing I'm not liking too much is less than before, Mike seems to be handling Dill back throwing. I mean, he used to get getting killed off of it, but now he's kind of go for fair if that situation is. And I think it's the...
Ooh. Lands the cross slash. Sends to the abyss. Dyer's got Mike Kirby off stage. He's gonna go for the help his teammate instead of going for the things. It's one of the things you gotta do is you gotta help your teammate over trying to get the gimp, in my opinion.
Yep.
It's all situational.
A slight problem that I'm having is people are kind of still ignoring how to DI versus Sheik. If Sheik is getting that forward throw on you at late percent, you do not want to DI in, you're gonna get up here.
Yeah.
Unless your teammate is there to apply the pressure and stop her from getting the hit in the first place, you want to be very, very careful. Because you don't want to lose stock.
Yeah. Send him.
Nice down air.
Good coverage from Dire, making sure that he's up there. Wes, oh wow, he just ran by him, trying to bait a reaction out of Dill, anything I can do. But Dill just sat there with the shield.
Yep.
Now we're back at this little reset situation. My Kirby's going to continue doing those D tilts because the needles will cover his options, so why not?
It's complete coverage here.
We call this the House of 3000 wall. Wow!
Wow, wall of 3000.
I like that. We'll keep it printed.
Oh,
Wes, you can't be going down there like that. Mike Kirby will definitely go down there and spike you.
Mike has no fear. He can have one jump left. If he knows he's going to make it, you're getting gimped. Very good jump air dodge here to avoid Dill's vanish. They'll probably say something.
No, I guarantee you they have like something going on.
Down throw, not going to connect into anything by Dire. Very unfortunate. They needed that stock.
I love when Wes just comes in and just throws out that dash attack and just hits all three of them. Resets the situation. Like, what neutral? Get out of here.
Yoshi's heavy enough that in a lot of these situations, even if all three are at even percents, unless it's like 150, it's perfectly fine for Wes to be putting out that hitbox because Dire is going to make it back to match.
Exactly. It's like reset.
Yep.
Get him out of that bad situation.
Exactly.
He was expecting Dill to jump in there with that cross slash, and Dill just stood there.
You have to be a little bit more careful in some of these situations, I feel, as both Cloud and Yoshi. Because you can't rely on reads too much when, you know, you framed it at... Wow. That was smart.
Mike Kirby's going to stay at the ledge, wait for Dill to come back.
In a lot of these situations, your kill moves are laggy, you know? Like, Cloud side B, it's not too laggy, but he's been getting punished for it almost every time. That's just not good. Misses the Nair, but he does get the force.
Wow, but then... Dire flying with him, goes up there, up airs him, does the riskiness because he knows he has to put out the risk if it's this close.
This is where comeback time comes. If Wes is able to keep...
Wes has gotten like three nairs on Mike Kirby.
Yeah. If Wes is able to keep the pressure off of him, Yoshi with rage is very good. He's going to be killing them in around 30%. Sheik is in kill percent. And at around 25, Kirby's in kill percent.
So. I like how Dire just ran in there and just dared both of the characters. Like, he spaced it. It looked like he was just going to aim for Mike Kirby, but then also follow Dill afterwards. Okay. So we're back to that neutral. Tries to go for that risky finishing touch. He went for it because if he would have landed, he would have got the kill, and now they're at a very bad position. Dire's at 162, but he does have max rage.
That was unfortunate, though, because I think he had the read there. He just kind of... Either he was a little bit slower, it was just finishing touch generally not being a good move in some of those situations.
Yeah, it comes out in 16 frames. You know, it's 16 frames for him to react to it, too.
That's slower than your reaction time, so you have to be very careful. Nice.
Dire's got him separated. This could be really good for him.
What Dire needs to do is, as long as he's not getting comboed by these two, Sheik is going to kill him in about 20% with forward air. But as long as he keeps himself out of that position,
that's going to be it. One thing I was loving that Dire was doing there was that he would like run into one, then run to the
other.
Like,
run to
like
the other. It's so smart because when you get a fake out like that, by changing the
pressure...
You got to
go after both opponents. Like, you got to change it up. Like,
if you're just changing it up, they don't know how to react. And especially when, like, I mean, Yoshi's grab isn't too good for this. I think Cloud would...